Good morning. Welcome to Christ the King Lutheran Church. I want to welcome all of our visitors, and I want to say I'm very happy to see Sun City. They are, and I serve there. I want to welcome you. That we may have met who your visitors are. Welcome. Oh, yeah? And we have somebody else back here. All right. Oh, some more. This is an awesome. Well, I think if there are no more, let's give them all a round of applause. Fortunately, we came the furthest. Just know that we're very happy you're here. And I want to invite you to meet me at the Labyrinth on Wednesday at 2 again. We are enjoying that. Most of you know how in love I am with out of the spirit of the desert. And also, Wednesday night, 5 o'clock, in the Nell's room, we have wonderful soup and desserts, and thanks to all who bring that food. And then we have devotions afterwards. So 5 o'clock we begin, and we try to get you out of here at 6:30 because long drives in the dark. So people that have asked to do announcements, so I'm going to go first. I think you're first.
And I will keep it short. So if you have not yet had your pictures taken for our church directory, this includes members, seasonal members, people who want to visit frequently. It's really going to be a tool for our new pastor, and as well as for Pastor Judith and others in the congregation. So see me in Nellis Hall. There's a little room back there. I've set up our consent for you to sign, and you can tell to whom you want that.
Thank you, and that is announced there. This congregation fixes the most amazing foods, so after this service, take a right into that room. And then also, if you haven't signed, do that so that I can get acquainted with you. Member, let me know about that. So I would like to do that sooner. So come and talk to me if that's what you're interested in. And Mary Sue, it's
good morning. We have three other guest musicians here today: Jan Meyer, David DeVault, and Abbott. They're not strangers, but they have performed here for the past 10 years. Last year, David came by himself because the airlines, the flight for AJ and so on, was canceled, so she couldn't make it. But she's here today. She's a soprano, bassoon, and Jan Meyer Thompson, pianist. I don't have a bio in for them, but I just want to tell you a little bit about Jan Thompson. A friend of mine since 1973, and the Ken Camerata, which we are all members of, throughout. She has served our church piano for us. So we also has been the president of the ASU Retirees Association, also the director of the children's program that she started. She's a wonderful musician and fabulous pianist. David DeBolt is also a professor emeritus of the Kansas University School of Music. He has performed at the Kansas City Philharmonic Orchestra, Birmingham, Tulsa, Santa Fe Opera, so on and so forth. So David DeBolt has been a colleague and a good friend of mine for many years at Kent State University. Amanda Joyce Abbott now teaches at the University of Mount Union and has also been a member of our Kent Camerata for a long time. Wonderful soprano, and she has been singing in Florence, Bologna, Italy, Ireland, and anyway, these are the three musicians we have today. Good morning, Lincoln. Another announcement is the Watoto first. There'll be a flyer out in the narthex for next week, and we have members of these fantastic program on the 21st, 7 o'clock on Thursday evening. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, and welcome, Lincoln. Thank you. And now we will, whoop. Oh no. I can still stay? Let's all relax and begin our worship.
Thank you.
Please stand. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who writes the law on our hearts, who draws all people together through Jesus. Amen. Held in God's mercy, let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Holy God, we confess our sins of sin and cannot break free. We hoard resources while our neighbors are hungry and cold. We speak in ways that silence others. We are silent when we should speak. In our hearts, we let hurts grow into hatred. For all these things and for sins only you know. Forgive us, Lord. Amen. Here is a flood of grace. Out of love for the whole world, God every snare of sin, washes away our wrongs of life through Jesus Christ. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And also with you. For the peace and salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Peace, God, and for the unity of all, let us for this holy house worship and praise. Let us pray to the Lord. Comfort and defend us, gracious Lord. Holy God, through your Son, faithfully and act courageously, Keep us steadfast in your covenant of grace, and teach us the wisdom that comes only through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and ever. Please be seated for the reading of the Word.
The reading today is from Exodus, the 20th chapter. God spoke all these words. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. No gods. Do not make yourself an idol. It's in heaven above. That is under the earth. Do not bow to them who worship them, for I am the God, punishing children for their iniquity, generation of those who reject me, steadfast love to the thousandth generation of those who love me and keep my commandments. You should not make wrongful use of the name of the Lord your God, for the Lord will not acquit anyone who misuses his name. Remember the Sabbath to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do your work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath to the Lord your God, and you shall not do any work, you, your son or your daughter, your male or female slave, your livestock, or alien resident in your towns. For the 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all in them, but rested on the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and consecrated it. Honor your father and mother, so that your days may be long in the land of the Lord your God has given you. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, male or female slave, or ox or donkey, or anything that belongs to your neighbor. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. heavens declare the glory of God, and the sky proclaims its maker's handiwork. One day tells its tale to another, and one night imparts knowledge to another. Although they have no words or language, and their voices are not heard, comes forth like a bridegroom out of his chamber. It rejoices like a champion to run its course. It goes forth from the uttermost edge of the heavens and runs about it to the end of it again. Nothing is hidden from its burning heat. The teaching of the Lord is perfect and revives the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure and gives wisdom to the simple. The statutes of the Lord are just and rejoice the heart. The commandment of the Lord is clear and gives light to the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean and endures forever. The judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. More to be desired are they than gold, more than much fine gold, sweeter far than honey in the comb. By them is also is your servant enlightened, and in keeping them there is great reward. Who can detect one's own offenses? Cleanse me from my secret faults. Above all, keep your servant from presumptuous sins. Let them not get dominion over me. Then shall I be whole, innocent of a great offense. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
The Holy Gospel according to John, the second chapter. The Passover of the Jews was near, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple, he found people selling cattle, sheep, and doves, and the money changers seated at their tables. Making a whip of cords, he drove all of them out of the temple, both the sheep and the cattle. He also poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. He told those who were selling the doves, "Take these things out of here. Stop making my Father's house a marketplace." His disciples remembered that it was written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." The Jews said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews then said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and will you raise it up in 3 days?" but he was speaking of the temple of his body. After he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scriptures and the word that Jesus had spoken. The Gospel of the Lord. In the third Lent, I don't know about you, but it seems faster. And before I go any further, I want to thank Sue Mayfield, who is doing such an awesome, awesome job with our bulletins. So today's scriptures deal with our priorities, the Ten Commandments. Proper respect for God and others is the heartbeat of these commandments and the rest of our readings today. In Psalm 19, which we heard in such a beautiful way, thank you, Jane, recognizes the power, sweetness, and beauty of God's word and brings us face to face with the darkness of sins lurking in our hearts, some that we are all too familiar with, and others that we have committed unknowingly. Confession shines the bright light of God's forgiveness into these dark corners of the heart and exposes them and cleanses them. This cleansing of forgiveness in turn brings freedom from guilt. Once forgiven, we have no reason to feel guilty anymore. In John 3, verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that whosoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. How much clearer could he be? We need to rejoice in that and be glad. I share with you, and this isn't a surprise for many of you, I continue from Pastor Holm, and you also are getting them now. But the ones I was getting before are different than the ones that you're getting now. Those of you that signed up for our Lenten 40-40-40-40 get devotions on the line or you received it in the mail, right? Some of you shake your head, so I know that's happening. Okay, so the ones I get are very similar, and I get those too, but this one, I wanted to reiterate what we've read today in the gospel reading. He uses a verse, making a whip of cords, he drove all of them out of the temple, both the sheep and the cattle. He also poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned the tables. Sounds pretty violent, doesn't it? If we were asked to describe Jesus, we would likely use words like wise, charismatic, loving, humble, and gentle. Yet passages like this, one from John, would indicate that we should also add the adjective angry to the list, because many struggle with anger issues. It can be difficult to even imagine that Jesus had those feelings, but he did. And a careful reading of the Gospels will show us many instances where Jesus expressed anger, and he did it without apology. So anger is an appropriate emotion for disciples of Jesus, but not in the ways that we often experience it. His anger was not out of control, explosive type that plagues us on the freeways or in conversations about politics. Jesus got angry at the misguided efforts of the Pharisees and scribes to make the law a burden. He got angry at the exclusion of sinners from God's grace and the grinding poverty of the poor. In the instance mentioned by John, he was infuriated at the systematic abuse of the temple sacrificial system. Certainly there will be times when we too are called to express righteous indignation at the ways people continue to be abused and neglected. Some of the things being done in our world deserve our angry and unapologetic responses. As disciples of Jesus, it really is our duty. And he asked the question, what makes me angry? What makes you angry? Stop making my house a marketplace. We're not to bring our offerings here so we can be entertained. We are to share from our abundance, not only money, but concern for others, and maintain this temple that we live in. We are all a temple of God. This is a temple. We can come to study words like we're hearing today. We can maintain our buildings like we do, and I want to say thank you to this congregation, especially the council, that passed a resolution to repair the air conditioning and the heat in our education room, because we have many, many people that come there during the week attending 12-step meetings, AA and Al-Anon. And when I saw the man shivering in there, I went, no more. I said, this has to be fixed, and it is fixed. Well, it's being fixed, and they're happy about it. They're celebrating. But we need to continue to share with people far and wide, but also on our own doorsteps. So think about that. What can you do for today, just for today, to share with others? Yesterday, I found myself in a laundromat. I haven't found myself in a laundromat for so long. I had a large piece, well, it was actually from the bed, a bedspread, and I had had company, and she had a dog, and it needed to go to the... Tried the cleaners, but they were closed, so we did the laundromat. So, first of all, I didn't know how to use the equipment. I can run an equipment, you know, AI, whatever, you know. So a kind lady gave me a quarter, said, put this in there, because, okay. And then I had some bills. I could get the rest of my change. But then her and another lady, we started having a conversation, because it takes a while standing in the laundromat waiting for the washing and drying to happen. So I learned a lot yesterday, but I also learned something from them that has touched my heart. I was sharing with them about last week, and Pastor Adele, coming here to speak about how we're going to be helping. We're going to get involved with Lutheran Family and Social Services attempts to help those people across the border who are seeking legal asylum. And I'm happy to say that Fountain of the Hills has put $2,500 toward that stove, that electric stove. We'll be working at matching that, so that's awesome. But this lady was listening to this, as was her friend, and we just had a nice conversation, and they had standing there waiting for my drying. She handed me this. Now, these women were not dressed or acting like they had lots of money. I don't know what that's like, but anyway. She gave me this, and she said, I want you to put this toward that stove. I had tears in my eyes. There's 10 quarters in here. And I thought to myself, how often do we miss the opportunity to share about our faith? How often do we miss the opportunity to maybe take this wonderful bulletin that Sue creates and share it with people we're visiting with? Because she has great words in here from the Bible and elsewhere. Fail to invite somebody to come and worship with us. What can we do about that? Can we find that in our hearts as we listen to these words? In John's Gospel, again, he says, after Jesus was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered what he had said, and they believed the scripture and the words that Jesus had spoken. When he talked about restoring the temple in 3 days, what do you think he the resurrection? And that is what we need to hold close in our hearts. Do we believe every word of the scripture today? I pray we do. I pray we believe every word that we have heard and that we share it not only with our words, but with our example. You've heard me say before, for some people, we may be the only Bible that they see. So go out there and share by what you say, by what you do, by how you're of service to other people. Not judging whether they're worth it or not. Just do it. Wednesday night, as I said, we get together. Oh, I think of that food too much. It's just awesome. Anyway, we get together and we dine and we socialize and we enjoy our time together and then we have a devotion. I show a little video, a Rob Bell video. And this last week it happened to be titled Today. And it was about letting go of the old sorrow and the regrets so that we can live today for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So I pray that we keep observing this Lenten journey that we're on and keep enjoying the Lenten devotions and confess our sins and then let them go. Let them go and let God. That's a simple phrase, let go and let God. Rejoice with love and live lives happy, joyous, and free with faith in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Let us pray. We know that you, Jesus, were talking about your body being raised up, and your words in our reading of John today signify that. After 3 days, we know it describes your resurrection. The Church of Christ has been resurrected and will live forever in the hands, hearts, and heads of faith communities forever. We know we are to live out your words in vibrant ways. We know that sometimes we forget that. So, Lord, refresh us, renew us, encourage us. And most of all, Lord, we hope you are patient with us as we go about sharing your love with others. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand for the hymn of the day. Let us profess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Trusting in God's promise to reconcile all things, let us pray for the church, the well-being of creation, and a world in need. You alone are God. We thank you for the gift of Sabbath rest. Awaken the church to the mystery of your presence and give us glad hearts as we receive the good news of your deliverance. Hear us, O God. You renew creation. Drive out those who would make the earth a marketplace. Protect rainforests, mountaintops, oceans, and wilderness areas from commercial exploitation. Unite nations, policymakers, and businesses in efforts to reduce carbon emissions. Hear us, O God. You judge the nations. We pray for an end to war and strife in every land. All the regions in conflict today bring about such sadness to our hearts. Strengthen international efforts to negotiate peace and provide humanitarian aid to people fleeing from conflict. Hear us, O God. You bring healing and hope. We give thanks for physicians, nurses, researchers, therapists, and public health workers who prevent and treat illness. We pray for any who are sick, especially those we name aloud or in our hearts at this time. We thank you, Lord, that Lorraine is back in our midst after her medical procedure. Hear us, O God. You abide with your people. Sustain us in this community and undergoing life transitions, marriage, divorce, childbirth, adoption, moving, graduation, and employment change, or death in the family. We pray for those preparing for baptism. Hear us, O God. You bring life from death. We remember our loved ones who have died, confident that they have new life in you. May we trust that nothing can separate us from your love. Hear us, O God. Accompany us on our journey, God of grace, and receive the prayers of our hearts through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. May the peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please be seated as we share from our abundance. please stand? Let us pray. Jesus, you are the bread of life and the host of this meal. Bless these gifts that we have gathered, that all people may know your goodness. Feed us not only with this holy food, but with hunger for justice and peace. We pray this in your name.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. And together we pray the prayer our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated, and all are welcome at the Lord's table. And if you need gluten-free bread, there is some here in the center dish. And if you want intinction, we have that. And if you want the little glass, they'll be there for you. So come, the table is ready. Please stand. May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Gracious God, at this table we have tasted your immeasurable grace. As grains of wheat are gathered into one bread, now make us one loaf to feed the world. In the name of Jesus, the bread of life. Amen. Beloved, we are God's own people, holy, washed, and renewed. God bless you and keep you, shower you with mercy, fill you with courage, and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Share your bread.